Mimir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, when victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
So what happened when Tyr brought Odin to Jotunheim?
Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word and his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared. No giants could be found in Midgard. And no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming!
Boy.
It says, glory to Mjolnir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Konùnsgard.
So, what brings you around, friends?
Well, don't buy anything on my account.
Whoa. Look. It's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge. Hostiles up ahead. On your mark.
Behind you.
It is over.
If the Dwarf King captured more than one dragon, he must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
The head is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that. That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh. Looks like it needs 3 entry stones.
Formidable duo! What if you try swinging the axe?
Focus up, boy!
Thank you.
you!
Focus up!
Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vadergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Devourer, Igor. The very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Still won't open? Looks like we need three.
Strong here. Go guard up.